In an earlier video, we compared two wide receiver statistics for yards per game for the 2018 season, and we saw that wideout one had a better mean, but wideout two had a lower standard deviation, meaning that he was a bit more consistent in being closer to his mean. Because the units of measure, yards per game, were the same, we could compare their standard deviations directly. But there is a way to compare the standard deviations of two different variables with different units of measurement by using what's called the coefficient of variation. Here are the formulas for the coefficient of variation for a sample and a population. For a sample, it's cvar equals s, the standard deviation, over x bar, the mean, times 100 to give a percentage. And for a population, it's cvar equals sigma, the standard deviation, over mu, the mean, times 100. So let's say that you wanted to compare the consistency of two athletes for their 2019 seasons, wide receiver Michael Thomas and baseball star Johan Moncada, yards per game versus hits per game. So we go through the calculations and see that Michael Thomas has an average of 107.8 yards per game with a standard deviation of 38.79. Moncada averaged 1.2 hits per game with a standard deviation of 0.98. So which player, based on these statistics, is more consistent? Using our formula, we plug in Thomas's numbers, 38.79 standard deviation over a 107.8 mean times 100 gives us 35.98% for his coefficient of variation. And for Moncada, we have a standard deviation of 0.98 divided by a mean of 1.2 times 100, which gives us 79.97% for his coefficient of variation. Since Moncada's coefficient of variation is larger, his data is more variable than Thomas's. So a higher coefficient of variation means the data is more variable. So in this case, I would say that Thomas is more consistent based on his data. All right, my friends, hopefully this video helped you out. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.